We mentioned that belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comprises the following. You believe Allah exists, they believe in His Lordship, they believe in His names and attributes, they believe in His rights upon you, which is the uluhiyya or the worship. So when I say al-Imanu billah, you come up with those four. You believe, number one, that He exists. He exists. Why do you need that? Because there are people who say God doesn't exist. We call those what? Atheists. So you need to prove to them that Allah exists. Now, you believe in His Lordship, in His names and attributes, and His worship. Those are four areas. Once it comes, so for your, if you're asked, what does it mean to believe in Allah? You mention those four. Right there. Tayyib? We're reviewing. Remember, when you call an atheist to Islam, is different to calling someone from the people of the book. When you call an atheist to Islam, you need to focus on Allah's existence. You need to focus on that part. Because he doesn't believe Allah exists. But when you talk to a Christian or a Jew, people of the book, about Islam, you focus more on the subject of the names and the attributes of Allah. And this is why a lot of our da'wah is not working. Because a lot of Muslims do not master that field. Because quite frankly, it's a very tricky. If you don't know how to sail, you will get in trouble. Because talking about Allah, about His names and attributes, there is a certain methodology to do that. For a lot of people, because they don't master it, then they don't talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the third thing here. Stay away from the Sharia side of the religion when you talk to those. It's a wrong way of da'wah, 100%. When the Prophet sent Mu'adh to Yemen, he said to him, start with La ilaha illallah. If they accept it, then talk to them about the salah, about the zakah, and so forth. Don't go and say, no, I can't drink, no. And Aisha mentioned what? The first things which we knew from the Quran, who is Allah? Huh? Does it, that He exists, names and attributes, lordship and actions, His worship. And what do you get if you do that? Jannah. And how Jannah is? What's in Jannah? And what will happen to you if you don't? Hell. And what's in hell? You're getting that. That's all.